The Plight of the Doorkeeper. A salute to church ushers. Somebody tell me, what was I thinking when I joined the usher board? I thought that by joining, I'd be serving my church and serving the Lord. But there's more to this job than standing guard. It runs so much deeper. 'Cause now I'm mad and my nerves are bad since I became a doorkeeper. You see, children disrespect me, and so do unruly adults. And then I get blamed for all the trouble, adding injury to insult. I feel like I'm about to lose my mind sometimes. I think my joy's been stolen. You see, my feet and my feelings are hurt, and my legs and ankles are swollen. Sometimes I feel like I'm the victim of all kind of verbal abuse. They testing my nerves while I'm trying to serve. I feel like, what's the use? It was David who said he'd rather be a doorkeeper in God's house. Well, David can have my uniform, honey. I think I'm getting out. But God told me to look at David. He was so unappreciated. He was kicked to the curb while trying to serve, but still dedicated. He was asked to take care of smelly sheep, and David said nothing to it. I know y'all think it's a dirty job, but somebody's got to do it. One day, Prophet Samuel came to visit at a time that God appointed. He had a horn of oil in his hand, 'cause you see, somebody's getting anointed. Jesse thought one of his favorite sons should be the natural choice. 'Cause that little runt back there keeping sheep, he'd be overlooked, of course. But David was shocked when he got word. Samuel wanted to see him. Somebody's about to be exalted, y'all. Nobody thought it would be him. But the oil in Prophet Samuel's hand was poured over David's head. Samuel stepped past the favorite sons, reached for David instead. The little shepherd boy who played the harp, who had always been neglected, was anointed king over his brethren, though once disrespected. You see, promotion doesn't come from the right or the left. Promotion comes from above. And the Father of Lights promised not to forget my labor of love. So I'll tolerate the hard-headed children and the hateful adults too. And I'll be sweet with my swollen feet and do what God called me to do. Lord, help me watch my temper and my lips that they speak no guile. 'Cause when I tell folk I represent you, I want heaven to smile. Now I think I understand what all my suffering is for. He's making me whole, saving my soul while I'm keeping the door.